All right, hi. Welcome, guys. We're going live. I'm Ryan, and I'm live. And first thing first, I wanted to ask you if you can see me, and if you can hear me, and if the audio is good. So I would appreciate it if somebody just leaves a comment and let me know if the audio is clear. I can see the video is working, so that's fine. But audio, I cannot be sure. So I would appreciate somebody giving me some feedback so we can start. Flying Monkey 200, thank you very much. All right, guys, as I told you, this is another 1 hour of question and answer. I'm trying to keep this up, and this will be the session for today, this week. I'm ready for your question. Shoot 'em up. Thank you, Raul. So guys, I don't know who is new here, who is on a regular basis, who is here for the not for the first time, has been here before. On Q&A sessions, I sit here and answer every question you have, the ones I can answer at least. So I wait for the first answer. Thank you, Ali Reza, for the feedback. Welcome, man. The very first question I got was from Raul, who said he wanted to become a professional like yesterday, and I sent him a link. Everybody else can just go and check that link because it's very, let me just pin it to the top. Guys, I just pinned the message to the top of the message. Make sure to check it out because I made this course with a lot of passion for you, with the help of a friend, and together we spent over 4,000 hours to create this video, shooting, editing, scripting, and it's a very valuable package that can just boost your learning to a different level. You will not be the same person anymore. You will be the guy that knows SolidWorks at work or in your university, especially if you're working or if you're going to find a job. You will not be that guy who just knows SolidWorks a little bit. You will be the guy they need to go to whenever they just face an issue. That's a guaranteed on that one. So let's see who else is coming. 3D sketching intro. Flying Monkey is asking, 3D sketching intro. Sure, good that you said intro because it's a very deep topic and it's not for beginners. It's basically for professionals. I can get into that in a second. Let's just see what other questions we have. Wirecut dies add-on. I'm sorry, I don't know about Wirecut add-ons. Not my area of expertise, I have to pass. Robin, hi, first time, welcome, man. This is a session where you can ask your questions and I'll try to answer them as long as I can, regardless of SolidWorks. Okay, so far I have a question from Flying Monkey, which I will answer first. Then there is how to keep from over-defining sketches. Raul, we just covered this in the last live session, so watch this one and go back to the previous live one on my channel. I covered that into detail. It's perfectly covered in the last one. So let's just see what we have. No more questions. Sarvana in the beginning. Hi, man. Thank you for joining. All right, let's get it started. No more questions. Right, we start with the first question from the Flying Monkey 200 3D sketching intro. Guys, you know, whenever you're drawing something in SolidWorks to extrude it or do other features on it, 99% of times you are working with 2D sketches. Even if you click on sketch over here, on default, you're activating the 2D sketch. But there is this 3D sketch option here, which is a little bit different. Firstly, for a 2D sketch, you definitely need to define a plane or a surface. So you cannot just keep drawing a 2D surface, 2D sketch in the space. You need a surface for that. But 3D sketches don't. So you can immediately pick 3D sketch and start drawing whatever you want. It gets a little bit tricky though. It took a while until I got a hang of it. First of all, the moment you activate the 3D sketch, like now, you are looking at it trimetrically. So first thing first, I recommend you press the spacebar on your keyboard because you need to look at each 2D plane at a time. What happens here is you are free to draw in all planes at the same time. Then at one go, you just rebuild your sketch. I'm just gonna pick, let's just pick line, it's easier to show you. So you can see next to my mouse cursor, we have a symbol that says XY. So it means I'm looking at the XY plane perpendicularly. So if I draw something, I will rotate the screen. I just hold, let me just shift on my keyboard and press the arrow to rotate the view 90 degrees. Sketch is still active. I'm gonna draw another one. This one was YZ. We go back to XY. We go back to YZ and I close this sketch. So look what happened. If I rotate it, this is it. This is a 3D sketch. Now you can do a lot of stuff with this, but getting into that would require digging deeper. It takes a lot of time. However, let me just quickly show you what general stuff you can do with 3D sketches. For example, I can try to create a plane like this by using Fill Surface, which is located in the Surface tab. It's a perfect tool to create a non-planar, not necessarily, but non-planar surface, which means zero thickness, that is bounded by a 3D sketch. Now, after that, if you want to add thickness to it, you can, let's just say 5. By the way, I'm working with the metric system. Those, if you're joining us from the States, ignore the units. You can just switch it to IPS if you want. I'm just showing everything regardless of their unit. Now, this is what I just did with that 3D sketch. It's a very deep topic and I don't want to get into that unless there is no more question or more people want to learn about 3D sketches. Then we can go ahead and dedicate the next, let's just say 10 or 15 minutes to 3D sketches. Then I will gladly walk you through the intro of that. So for that, if you are interested for 3D sketches topic, let me know how many people are interested in the chat section and I'll decide which way to go. Going back to the questions. So that was for Flying Monkey 200. Wire cut, I said I'm out. Raul is asking how to keep from, okay, over-defining, I said previous video, freedom, energy. I've seen you before. He says, I need to see how to adjust the sketch tab, yours is square, mine is rectangle. Sketch tab? You mean this tab over here is this? I'm not following. Freedom Energy, what do you mean my sketch tab is square and yours is rectangle? Is this what you mean by that? No. Please clarify. All right, Raul, okay. Muhammad, send a message. Retracted, same with Robin. Probably their questions have been answered. Rafat says, how to add formulas to designs? I think I did this before, but quickly for those of you guys, because it's a very interesting topic. Again, it's not for beginners. However, if you ask me, beginners can benefit the most from this because as you start learning SolidWorks, at some point, you don't want to stay beginners. You definitely don't want to stay beginners. You want to move your way up to the professional level, and equations are very useful for that. So first of all, I'm going to draw whatever here, go to tools and select equations here. I have already created the shortcut for it. Next time, I'm not going to go to the menu. I'm just going to press Control E on my keyboard. So you know what I press on my keyboard when this window show up. We have a couple of columns here. The ones that matter are this one, name, value or equation, and these two are basically not for you to change. It's only for preview. So you only pay attention to this column and this column and ignore everything else here, except make sure that the automatically rebuild is ticked or checked. Let's just say I'm gonna say add a new global variable. Let's just call it height and assign a value of 100 to it, and I'm gonna add length, also let's just say 200. All right, now when I go back to my sketch and activate smart dimension, which is here, just click anywhere. Instead of typing a numerical value, I'm going to type equals, then type height. Now if I click on height, it will be added here as an equation. And when I click OK, you see that sigma symbol next to my value. It means I cannot simply change the value. It's being controlled by the equations. And I'll show you how to control it in a second. Now, this time, I'm going to do this for height. That was one. I should have picked length, but it doesn't matter. This time, I'm going to pick length with one minor difference. Pay attention, guys, because this is changing everything. Last time in the previous step, I typed equals, then I selected height, which I should have selected length, but doesn't matter. The important thing is I typed the symbol equals. This time I'm not gonna do that. If I don't, I get the same value, but I don't get the sigma symbol next to my dimension. It means I just copied the value, the current value of length here, but it's not being controlled by equations. If I go and change my equation, this one would not change. So let me just fix it quickly. Always make sure to press equal, otherwise you're wasting or making a mistake basically. Length 200 and click OK. Now this is our sketch. Let's just give it some quick extrusion. Going to the equations tab, change this one to 300. So it's now 300, and let's just make it shorter and make it 100. And that's what it happened. If I wanted to do this for the equation, I could have done it this as well. Equals height. I only have defined two variables. So, and that's it. Next question quickly. That was for Rafat Sina. Robin is asking, how can I join two pipes of same dimensions? I did, but as we did machining, gaps were there. How can I join two pipes of same dimension? Well, Robin, I'm assuming, I'm sorry, I've been pronouncing your name right. I just noticed a little German in my head. I'm assuming you're talking about two pipes, cylindrical pipes with the same outer diameter, perpendicular, you mean? So you want to connect two perpendicular cylindrical pipes. Guys, by the way, just continue writing, doesn't matter. These are a little bit time consuming because I have to create and prepare some models for you in order to answer your questions. So I hope I can do it fast so I can answer as many questions as possible today. So we have one pipe here. I'm gonna start the other pipe here and I just extrude it a little bit from this plane outward 100. How about that? Make it thin feature. Doesn't work, doesn't matter. Deactivate thin feature and uncheck merge results. I'll fix it in a bit. This is the one. Well, I don't know if you, this is what you need because this would be the best way to create that pipe, but it depends on what you necessarily need it for. One is fine. Reverse, click OK. And start extrude cutting this that way, not here. All right, this is how I would have done it. And if you don't like this bit, just cut it off with a plane or a sketch. Just click OK. You go to Surface tab, cut with surface, and get rid of the other half like that. So I think you wanted something like this. And if you already have two pipes, you cannot join them together perpendicularly because these are cylindrical. So you're going to have to fill that gap with something. And I know what gap you're talking about. And this is from this line, basically this triangle here. Watch this video. You can go back right now or after the video. Watch what I did a couple of times. And this is what you should do for your pipes. All right, formulas, perpendicular, I just answered. Alireza is asking, do you have any tutorial packages? How we can purchase them? I do, Alireza. I just quickly to get back to you, there is a full course on SolidWorks that I have made. I will explain it a little bit more after I answer the questions, but shortly for now, the comment pinned on top of the chat box is perfect for you. Make sure to go there and check it, but I'll explain a little bit more at the end. Freedom Energy, your close on it. Okay, so going back to your question, you said, I need to see how to adjust the sketch on. Oh yeah, the square one. Freedom. Your clothes on it. Honestly, can you paint a picture or explain a little bit more detail? I don't understand your first question. Sketch tab is this one. This is a sketch tab. And you're telling me my sketch tab is square and yours is a rectangle. I don't know what you mean by that. Okay, until you answer this question. Hi, Alala, welcome. Good to have you here. Dracula, I remember you from last time. You're interested in the 3D sketches to see if it applies to your unanswered questions from the last session about creating parts between defined planes, that is, creating a known space to develop a part within. The 3D sketches to see if it applies to your unanswered question. Well, help me out here, man. I cannot go back and check it. I don't remember what exactly your unanswered question was. If you could just type it quickly, I will get back to you as soon as possible. By the way, guys, there are two videos dubbed on my channel. Maybe it's interesting. One of them is how to create new planes. And one of the other one is actually on this very page you're watching the video. If you go down, there is a red and green bolt and nut. So these two videos were dubbed by Alale. A lot of you have asked me who has done this, what voice is this? Most of the comments are about the voice, and she's actually now in the chat, I just saw her. Moving on to the next question, Sarvana says, she has drawn 7 extrude in 5th extrude. I'm sorry if I'm saying your title wrong, but I'm assuming it's a she. She drawn extrude cut in top mistakenly. Can I change to bottom 5th extrude cut after 7 extrudes? I cannot follow. This is one of those questions, guys. If you want to get the best answer, guys, when I say everybody, when you want to get the best answer to your questions, try to paint a picture for me. If you just talk generally about the fifth extrusion in your project, I don't know what project you're working on. I need to know. So make it as simple as possible. Try to give as much detail as possible, relevant details, and I will try to answer that. Otherwise, the question will be too vague, and others also don't learn from your question, and worst of all, I don't get what you're trying to ask me, and I cannot answer. So, to Freedom, I see you have already answered. I will get to it. And Sarvana, try to re-explain the question. So let's see what energy, Freedom Energy has said. All your sketches, all your sketch tools up in left corner are in a square. Okay. My sketch tools are rectangle, horizontal along the top. I think I'm getting what you're saying. So if you want to move this, let's just quickly drag like this. Like if you want to move it out, I think you're talking about something like this, right? You're in rectangular mode somewhere along the interface of SolidWorks. If this is the issue, just let's just double click this. Put it back. It's probably been dragged out, and all you have to do, let's just put it back, double click on it or drag it out like this one. Look, if I drag this one, it will be back. Double click it, it would be going in its right position again. So this is only the interface. if you cannot do this, just go back to your, just go to your settings and click on reset. Hopefully it will fix it there. But you don't need to reset anything. Malik says, which license should I take to get a good job? So Malik, a question about job in SolidWorks. First of all, it very much depends on what you're going to do with SolidWorks and what that job requires to do, requires you to do. If you're going to do some simple modeling, you don't need any surface modeling, you don't need any simulations, you don't need any this, any that, just basic, you can get a standard. If you're trying to do, I don't know, a lot of 2D sketches, for example, in my industry, we need to do a lot of 2D sketches for designing implants. And for that, I would recommend a professional or a premium license. Again, it all goes down to the functions you need. So if you tell me what kind of job you're seeking, maybe I will be able to give you a more detailed answer. Until then, my answer will be very general because it very much depends on the job. All right, the Flying Monkey 200 is back. Could you go over using the swept cut tool with sketch profiles? Absolutely, I can. All right, guys. Swept cut. Let me see if I have anything open. What part should I just bring this one. All right, so let's just combine all the questions I have been getting in this session so far and create something useful to it. I'm gonna go to 3D sketch and I'm gonna draw something randomly with spline. Hopefully I'm within the part. Oh, I'm not by any means. Forget it, takes time, but. So this is a 3D sketch. It's within the part, that's fine. Let's just make it very 3D, like that. Now we have this, and you wanna use swept cut. It's just pretty much like swept boss. I'm gonna click on it. Since I haven't defined any profile, I will just click on the circular profile, select the path, and it will just do the job for me. If you don't know if it has, look at the position of the hole. It keeps moving, look. If I just drag my cross-sectional view, the hole moves along the path. Now, if you wanna do it with a different type of profile, no problem, you just have to draw that on a plane that cuts your path, which is the line you're gonna swept it along, and make sure that plane is perpendicular to your path or as perpendicular as possible. Quickly, I'm gonna do a hexagon. Something like this. Now this time, Ryan notices his profile was not on the path. So what I do is select them both by holding Control key on my keyboard and make him go pierced. They don't because of a 3D probably. So let's just see if I can drag it. Oh, no, it's defined. I'm sorry, my bad. Now we can do it, pierce. Now, we have a profile, hexagon, we have a path, we wanna go swept cut it, easy. Select your profile first, select your path next. Now since my profile is not at either end of my path and it's in the middle, I get three options. Do you wanna go one way, do you wanna go that way, or do you wanna go both ways? I'm gonna go both ways and this is how it looks like. So that was a quick answer to your question. Moving on next, we have Rafatina. How much values can we relate to each other? If we change global variable values, will it change it all for other values related? Absolutely. That's the whole purpose of equations. If you use a global variable in a different equation, once you change that, everything that that is connected and dependent on that follows. So after that, we have Mohammed. He's asking, hi, how to make gears directly from library like spur gear. Oh, wow. I haven't done this for a very long time. Let's just see if I have gears here. Well, spur gear is here. You can, I'm not in the blank page, but you can configure it here. by right-clicking on it, click on configure. The toolbox is not something everybody has. As a matter of fact, I got this question from one of my members today. He's using educational versions. Let me close this while I'm talking. And he was asking me if it's included in the educational version. It's really hard to talk, think, and also do. So sorry for that. So that's how you do it. Who asked this? Muhammad, that's how you do it. You go to library, you just open the box, right-click on the spur gear, click create component, and then you can adjust it here. Number of teeth, whatsoever, and it will be adjusted. All right, moving on to the next question. We have Dracula. How do I make planes to connect between, like, pipe manifolds with multiple tubes from one area having to merge at another? How do I make planes to connect between, like, pipe manifolds with multiple tubes? Are you talking about, so I'm talking to you directly, are you talking about a pipe that comes out and branches out into so many pipes? Is this what you're asking me? If it is, then tell me. If it's about making planes, then again, the same video I mentioned that she dubbed it. Alalele, just quickly, just type SolidWorks, create new planes. The very first video is my video, and I explain how to create planes, if this is your question. If you're talking about the pipe that branches out, then give me a yes. If it's something else, then please describe more. Whale, hi back. How do you verify the mass of this material? So the mass of a material depends on the part. So it's easy, you go back to your part. First of all, you need to assign a material. Let's just say if it's brass, then you can go to evaluate tab, click on mass properties, and you see your mass is written here in grams in this case, or pounds if you're using IPS. So it was in evaluate tab, mass properties. It gets even better. You get more information like density, volume, surface area, and so on. Right. Just a second to catch my breath. We have Freedom. You got what I was asking, but how do you unlock it? Mine won't move. Yours, how can you lock? I'm not sure if you can lock it, man. Just so if you drag it, it doesn't move. That's weird. Look, if I go here, it even gives me a pop-up. Put it back. I don't know. I've never seen that your command managers are locked. Try to reset. Go to settings and click on reset. See if it fits. If it gets fixed, and let me know. So Rafat says, is SolidWorks good in 2D sketching or other software like AutoCAD will be better for 2D? Absolutely. AutoCAD beats SolidWorks in 2D sketching. As much as I hate to say it, I'm a SolidWorks guy. I'm a SolidWorks fan. And I really love SolidWorks in every way. As much as it's good in 2D sketching, it doesn't reach the level of AutoCAD for 2D. Because if you're working with SolidWorks, especially in 2D, and you're sketch becomes messy, you use a lot of entities, it slows down exponentially. And the tools you get on AutoCAD to change and adjust your entities at the same time makes your job much easier, and you can work way faster. So in this case, I prefer AutoCAD for 2D. Sarvana, okay. Can rib function work in two cylinder bodies? For example, in perpendicular pipe you drawn before. No, actually, yeah, you can, because rib function, it's nothing more than an extrusion, a simple extrusion, but they have made a function out of it, because in structure, and when you're designing structures, it's very useful to have a feature. Basically, it's nothing more than drawing a sketch and extruding it. So if you can do it with a simple sketch, you can do it with ribs. But the thing is, where do you want to put a rib on a cylindrical surface? It doesn't make that much sense. Unless it does in your case, in your project, then you can. You just select the plane and then, select the plane, front plane, go to ribs, and then start drawing whatever you want to do, and then just use ribs like that. But it doesn't, again, it doesn't look really good. It doesn't work because my sketch is not connected to the body of my cylinder, but if it did, it would work. All right. Dracula, yes. Is that a yes to, wow, I have to revert back. What did I ask you? I said, man, you have to tell me yes to what, because I remember I gave you three options, so it's not option three. It means I got it right in one of the first or second guess, but I don't know yes to which one and which one. Quickly tell me yes means what. Gotham, can we draw two-part diagram in single plane? Two-part diagram. What do you mean by two-part diagram in a single plane? I believe so. I if I get your question right, your answer is yes, and I can show you. But please clarify, what do you mean by diagram? I'm not sure. Dracula, sorry for my wording not being super helpful. No, man, don't worry about it. It just, let me clarify something in a second, Dracula. The thing is, I'm getting a lot of questions, guy, and I don't want to miss any questions. So the questions are piling up, and I'm trying to answer the questions. Maybe I have to come up with a system limited down to X number of questions per session, because I want to answer all of your questions, and I don't want to, at the same time, I don't want to just scratch the surface and move on. I want to give you some more value. That's how I like to teach it. But if I do that, I miss the other question. So don't worry, it's only a challenge that I have to figure out how to solve. It's not your problem, but it does help if you describe your questions as clear as possible and keep it short. So my Diaz says, how to know when a part breaks in simulation? I'm not really expert in simulations. To answer your question, I have to say I don't know, because it's a very deep topic, and then it goes down to how do you know a part breaks down? I have to think about it, but the short answer, I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm not an expert in simulations in SolidWorks. Raul, I have things to do. I will look into it. Thank you. You're welcome. Dracula, I'll send an email with a picture for another session. Thank you. You're welcome. Gotham, two-part in a single plane. Yeah. So to answer Gotham, two-part, you can do as many parts as you want in a single plane, man. It doesn't have to be. And by part, I believe you mean a solid body. So this is a single plane. And this is part one. This is part two. This is part three, if this is what you're asking me. So look, I have three parts, but all of them in one single plane. Is this what you're asking me? Look, we have three solid bodies. As long as these are not connected to each other, they count as a single solid body, and they are all located on one plane. You can do as many as you want. Mohammed says, in my SolidWorks, this eye, and he has put an emoji of two eyes, somehow is not available to preview something. What do you mean that those eyes are not a thing in SolidWorks, man? I'm not following. In your SolidWorks, okay, you have to describe it again. I don't know what you mean by that. And what is Sumbal? Rafat, is it possible to make template in SolidWorks to get rid of the repeat? Absolutely. What kind of template you're talking about? There are different templates for your drawing sheet, for example. You could do that. But if you're talking about a template in model, I don't know. I don't think so. Is there a template for a model that you need? You're welcome, my dears. Adarsh says, how can I create a shield, completely hollow from inside? You mean sheet metal or, please, what do you mean by shield, completely hollow from inside? Is that a word? Maybe it's my knowledge that lacks shield. Let's just see what shield means. Shield. Shield monad. You don't mean that. I don't know. Describe that, please. Gotham says, thanks, brother. Clear, thank you very much. You're from India. Thank you. You're welcome. Sarvana, how to extrude different values for two or more parts in one sketch? So, Sarvana, it's a very good question. I think I have covered this before, but quickly just to show you, when you have a sketch that has more than one closed boundary, one closed area, you can simply reuse that sketch as many times as you want. So you have two closed sketches here. I'm gonna select the first area here in the selected counters, extrude it as much as I want. Then once this sketch is disappeared, it doesn't mean it has served its purpose and you cannot reuse it. I can simply open the feature, select the sketch by one simple left click, go back to extrude, and select the second area and readjust its value and click OK. Right. All right. Adarsh, shell. Oh, OK. So you want to create a shell completely hollow from inside. I get it. So you have a closed solid body like a sphere. Guys, pay attention, because it used to be something that I was really curious about. That's why I got a little bit excited. So if I'm not mistaken, I hope I'm not, Adarsh is asking how to shell out a component completely from inside. And this is something I was dabbling with. I came up with some solutions, self-made solutions that I built on my own. I'm not sure if it's the most ideal way to do it in SolidWorks, but I'm happy to show you the way I do it. So if you have a sphere and you want to shell it out, or a different solid body, how do you do that? Because if you select it, it doesn't work that way. So how does it work? How does it work? Well, there are different ways. You could just, instead of going for the full part, cut it in half, make it shell, mirror it, and duplicate it so at the end you have a cylinder or a sphere. But in this case, I'm gonna do something different. I'm going to open a small gap into my component like this. So let's just like this, and then it doesn't have to start from the middle, just start from here or 80 and go up that way. Now, what I did is I just created this. If I go to shell and select this and this, I shell the whole thing. Look, the whole sphere is shell. Now all is left for you is to close this gap, which is, again, easy. It's not that difficult because you already have the sketch for it. Click on that. For from, you change it to surface. You pick the inner surface. And for direction one, you select up to surface and you select the outer surface. And now, this way. You can also merge it, I hope. And now the gap is closed. So in three steps, I shell the part in the middle and I close the gap. This is my Ryan's made solution. Maybe there is a better solution to it. I think I already knew another way, but I cannot remember it right now. So my ideas, if you need a template, make a part, copy paste solid SolidWorks part file and change things you need. Oh, thank you. Yeah, that's the answer to, I think, Muhammad's question. Avito is back. Is SolidWorks simulation coming to the course? No, Avito, SolidWorks simulations is not included. We have we had another question before you joined about simulations, and I said I don't consider myself an expert in simulations. I know my way around. I don't get stuck. I can do my... If I need to do something in simulation, I can do it. But in order to teach it, I like to have a certain level of confidence and knowledge in that topic in order to teach it. Now, the course you joined is for people who are absolutely beginners and they want to reach to the level of professional up to the CSWP. And as you probably know, simulation is not included in the CSWP exam. Right. Lenoid, hi. Is there a built-in function to do the convex stamp on the only using one sketch on the surface? Is there a built-in function to stamp? So no, there is not a stamp function. You have to create your stamp, whether it's a text or a picture, and then engrave it onto your part. Or do you engrave it? Adash, oh damn, this is a new, this is new. Oh, you're welcome. Muhammad, preview icon. Yeah, what do you mean by that? Lenoid, whoops, I mean, on the surface. Yeah, same, same. Oh, you mean on the surface? Stamp. Well, if I'm not sure if this is what you mean, but there is a feature called, where is it? I don't use surfaces that often, but I believe there is a feature for that. Maybe it's not on the default menu. Let me just check here. I don't see it. Customize, commands, surfaces. Let's see, I think it's this one, replace. Or yeah. I'm gonna have to pass this one. I believe this is this one which we had here. Replace. But let's just see. Replaces face in a surface or solid body with a new surface bodies. No, it's not this one. I have to get back to you on this because I knew this, I used it, but this is not something that I use that often. I remember I used it years ago, but it's been a while. I have to check. Which CSWP? There are 7 CSWP. The default CSWP Mekeng exam, because there is, you're right, there is CSWP for simulation even, there is CSWP for sheet metal. There is one for weldments and so on. I'm talking about the default for mechanical engineering. Okay, so how much time it takes to master SolidWorks? I just started a month ago. Adarsh is asking, how much should you practice weekly? So basically, it's like asking me how much time it requires for you to become a master in playing piano. It depends on how you practice, what you practice with, and if you are following a right sequence to learn. Otherwise, you'll forget, guaranteed. If you, let's just first assume you're doing everything right and it's only a matter of time, and you wanna be master, okay, so you wanna master SolidWorks, assuming that's a professional level, certified SolidWorks professional, CSWP, what I was just talking with Avito about 2 seconds ago. You need to put down a daily practice of, depending on how fast you learn, 2 hours a day for, say, three, four months, I would say, if you follow everything right. If you want to do trial and an error on your own, years, guaranteed, over many years, 2 years, 3 years. If you know what you have to learn first, what you have to learn next, how to learn it, when to use it, when not to use it, then 3 months or so. Otherwise, countdown on years. And I have a perfect solution for you. Just wait a couple of minutes until we have 12 more minutes to answer questions, and I have the best solution for you. I will tell you in about 10 minutes or so. So some message was Sumaya was deleted. Khaled, hello Ryan, can you show us how to make mold from complicate from a complicated product, from a complicated one. Well, that depends. What is a complicated product? I'm not really okay. I'll show you this one because this is not what I work with all the time. Mold tools here. This is something I used to work with a lot when I was in university for my project, but I haven't been using it for a very long time. So let's see if I still remember everything. You need everything from here, simply said. These tools here are basically surfacing tools. Mold tools, guys, or mold tab basically offers you tools to create a mold for your part, perfect for injection molding, for example. Now, it shares a lot of features and commands with surface modeling. For example, all you see here is all you see here as well. Going to mold tools, what you need to follow is parting lines to the right. So this is what you follow. Let's just say we have this component and I want to get rid of this weird hole inside it, make it very simple, and you want to create a mold for it. I'm going to go ahead and create my first parting line, select the surface, draft analysis first of all. It looks good. And click OK. Now we have our, I'm sorry, it's not good. You have to select the edges. Just clicking on this would do the job. Close one area, which I'm doing. So this is where my mold opens. Now the message is green. You can see that it's OK. You can click OK. Moving on to shut off hoses in case you have any hole. We don't have any holes in this case, and you go to parting lines. This is fine, let's just leave it at that. It gives you a surface. Basically, this is where the mold opens. You go to tooling split, you select the surface, and you're gonna have to draw your the outer body of your mold. Just say, I wanna draw something like this. It needs to be bigger than your component, and it needs to be smaller than your surface. So in this case, this will do. And it needs to cover your component all the way like this from both ends, and click OK. Now, this is my mold. If you want to see how it looks, let's just see. Wait. There is a new tool that I don't know. Maybe it shows the core. No. Let's just not get distracted. I'm going to use Move Copy Body to open the mold. This is one. And this is the second one, the other half. And I want to hide the surface over here. You can see that. Let's just move this a little bit further, all the way out. So this is my mold. You can see that. This is the component in the middle. This is the first half of the mold, and this is the cap of the mold. Now, if I had my parting line in the middle, then the mold would have been divided almost equally. Right, I didn't go to a more complicated part because it would, I'm not sure if I can do it in this short time. There might be problems that I face, and in order to solve it, I need to put down time. I haven't used it for a very long time, but this is the gist of it. If you want about mold tools more, let me know how many of you are interested. So next time I'll dedicate 10 or 15 minutes for molding tools. How about that? Okay, so MQ Gaming is asking, is YouTube a good source to learn SolidWorks? Well, MQ, I started learning from YouTube when there were only three single videos about SolidWorks on YouTube. I uploaded the fourth. And to answer your question, no, it's not. Why? Because if you are a beginner, and I assume you are because your question is about learn SolidWorks, it's not a good source because you have all the materials on YouTube, sure, you can find everything and anything multiple times on different channels. But the issue is, these are like pieces of puzzles that are scattered all over YouTube, and you don't know what belongs to what comes first, what comes next. For example, if you want to create a loft in SolidWorks, you need to know how to create a custom plane first. if you learn or if you are interested to create Loft and you just search a video for topic Loft, which is a tool, you see it here, and you don't know how to create a plane, you're gonna have a hard time pulling that off. So the problem with the videos on YouTube is it's not organized well. It's not in a sequential mode. You just learn the alphabets like Q, S, B, C, F, G, H, Z instead of A, B, C, D, E, F, G, right? You get the gist. So this is the issue. The contents are there, but there is no clear pathway. If you're interested in learning SolidWorks, and I think I forgot, somebody else also asked it, Adash, or and another, some other people, Alireza. If you really want to learn SolidWorks, just go to top of the chat. I have pinned a message. This is a link to a course that I have created. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't come free because it took me a full year to create it, and it's still not finished. It's still ongoing. More than many thousand hours of work to create a perfect product that covers everything you need in a sequential order from zero knowledge to all the way to professional CSWP. So take a look at that. And guys, this is, I haven't announced it officially, but Black Friday is around the corner. If you want to join, you might want to wait until next Friday because we will announce a discount and the course will be at its cheapest. Then the price will go back to its normal after that. So this is a hint for this video, only for those who are watching it live. All right. Who asked this question? I have to find it. MQ. Yeah, I hope I answered your question to your satisfaction. Avito says, I'm attending the AU 2020 conference, and then, is it still taking place? I thought they canceled everything. And then applying that to SolidWorks. Also, I'm learning from your course and applying Infusion 360. For example, yeah, good, Avito. That's a very good one. Avito is asking, can SolidWorks be used for character figure making? Yeah, as a matter of fact, I thought no, but yes, it can. It requires heavy surface modeling skills, which is not easy. I have seen some models from some other fellow SolidWorks professionals with surface modeling. They can't, it's, you can do it. However, I don't recommend it because SolidWorks is not made for that. So you could have a much more or much easier time working with more suitable CAD software for that. SolidWorks is can pull that off, but it's not ideal. Now, MQ, if you're still watching, let me know, because the next comment below, Avito, he is a student of the course that I told you I have created, and you can, Avito, I don't know if you don't mind just sharing your experience from the course that I was just talking about. Let MQ and others know if you're happy with it and what you think about it in general. Lenoid says, if we have sheet metal and some sketch on it, let's say simple round, and I need to push this round, you mean circle, into the metal. Let's say it's press pushing 1 millimeter in. How can I model this? So you have a sheet metal and you want to press like a rod into the metal and see its effect in simulations, because I think you asked, was it you? Or wait, it continues. So it's convex on the sheet metal. I'm not sure about this term in English, sorry. I'm not sure about it either, but I know what you mean. You're trying to forge it into the metal and see the deformation into that. I'm not an expert in sheet metal, again, because guys, SolidWorks goes like beginner, intermediate, professional, well, CSWA, professional, CSWP, which is where I am. Then it continues on different levels parallel to the CSWP for sheet metal, for simulations, for weldments, for such and such. And this doesn't fall in the category that I work with. But I know there is this forming tool, and you can see even the symbol on that is exactly what you're looking for. I'm not going to do it now because I haven't used this tool before, but I am working with Hubert, who is also a CSWP special in sheet metal and weldments, and he has created some perfect tutorials for sheet metals. Write me an email at info@solidworkstutorials.net. I will pass it to Hubert and ask him to get back to you. Sarvana says, upload many videos about plane creations, hole wizards, relation tools, and GDNT. Well, first of all, I don't have videos about GDNT. It's a very good topic, but I have to first create them. Hole wizards, first of all, plane creation, I told you, the video is there. Just type create new planes in SolidWorks. The very first video that shows up is my video. Make sure the name of the channel is mine. The first one is, and it's perfectly explaining everything you need to know. GDNT, I don't. Sketch relate. Wait a minute. Thank you. Hole wizard. Hole wizard is not that difficult. All you have to do is to define the type of hole you want to create and the position. So you start with the type, which you have 9 of. And then you just change the parameters as you wish. If you want to work with anisometric, if you want to work with ISO, if you want to work with DIN in Germany, whatever. And let's just pick one. Then you just change the sizing, what type. Let's just say M5, fit, normal, loose, or close. What type of fitting for the threads. Sorry for the shaft of the screw. If you want to custom that, tick custom sizing. And after you're done with all of that, you go to the position tab and you pick some positions and place your hole. And let's just say like this, another one. It's not that ideal, but I'm going to do it. Click OK. Now you have two here. Unfortunately, it was set to through all, so it's cutting everything. Ignore these two. Let's just get rid of them quickly. They don't exist. And if you want to duplicate these or pattern these, open the hole wizard you just created, sketch, edit sketch. Now I can go to, let's just say, circular pattern, pick this one up, do it 4 times, that's fine, and click OK. Now look what happened. I just created a pattern out of that hole wizard. So basically, it's a very straightforward procedure. You select the type, you customize it, you go to positions, and you apply it. Well, guys, I cannot catch up to the questions. Where was I? When will be your next live? Well, I'm trying to go live at least once a week on YouTube, but maybe I'll do it 2 times a week this week. I'll let you know. Just guys, if you're watching this, and I'm sorry if I say guys all the time, everybody, people, make sure not only click on subscribe, but click on that bell button, because the new algorithm on YouTube works in a way that even whether or not you're subscribed to a channel, you don't necessarily get the videos from that channel when they are going live or when they're uploading a new video. So make sure to click on that bell button. And when next time I'm going to go live, you get notified and you won't miss it. That was for Sarvana. Avito, how to backtrack and reverse engineer a design to understand how to make it. Well, there is a tool for that, but you can just do it manually. That tool does nothing more than rolling this sleeve up to the very first component you just did. In this case, it's hidden because I forgot I did this. Just put it back. So you put it up, then you roll it down step by step, and you see exactly the steps I have done to create whatever component I have done. So let's just open another one. Let's just see this one. I think I did this last week. You go all the way up. So first thing first, it was this. If you want to see how I did it, you open it. Good. I activate the draft at 20 degrees, extruded 21.6. Good, you know that. Go down, there's an extruded cut. Go down, extruded boss. And if you want to see the details, again, you go into the feature, edit feature, and you read. So for example, why I have selected an edge here, and this is this edge, because I wanted to define the direction of the extrusion, for example. And the feature that does this for you is located in the Evaluate tab called Part Reviewer. So if I put this all the way down, not all the way, maybe up to here, it does the same thing for you. You can click on Step by Step Moving, like that. You see what happens? It just, oh, my mouse. Just moves that line down in the design tree, and you see what's going on. It's called Part Reviewer, but it does nothing more than what I just showed you. All right. Oh, that's on online. Okay, good. Khaled is asking, making some mold design tutorials in the future will be great. Point one. Okay, Khaled one. More people. Avito, it's super good. Okay, so Avito is, guys, the comment below Khaled, where Avito, I asked him to share his experience about the course that he joined, enrolled in, and he says, it's super good. I too did not know much at first. Now I'm decent enough and will answer CSWP in December. Really? Keep me posted. I'm really excited for that. Good, good. That makes me happy. I got a special limited student discount. Yep, we did that back then. Lenoid, not simulation. I mean, it's just part of the model. Okay, I think you're talking about the sheet model, sheet metal, and I told you, just email that. And I'll have him answer you. Avito, maybe a video explaining what M10 means and what the size of the shaft. Okay, so it goes a little bit technical. I'll think about it. I don't promise it, Avito. Forming tool, yes. Again, email. Avito, can I snap a line, the whole wizard to a line or a given point? Oh, guys, by the way, it's 10 minutes past 1 hour. I have to wrap this up. Abhishek says, okay, Avito, did you just open some kind of magnifying glass? Yes, if you press G, you open the magnifying glass on the keyboard. That's a shortcut for it. How to show dimensions in 3D model. If you want to work, that's Dim Expert, Rafat. I'm a little bit distracted because I have to wrap this up quickly. If you show up in the next live session, I'll show you how to work with Dim Expert to work to show your dimensions in a 3D model like this one, for example. Now you can make it look better. Guys, this is the end of this live session. It's 8 p.m. here where I am now in Germany. A little bit tired. I've been working on different videos that I'm going to upload soon on the course. And if you don't know about the course called SolidWorks Course Pro, make sure to click on the link in the description of this video below or in the chat on the top. I have pinned it. It's the perfect course, the new course that allows you to learn SolidWorks in the right sequence easily, that comes with a bunch of cool bonuses like two PDF tutorials, one of which has 2,100 pages of tutorial to create a tiger tank from scratch to end. So you create every single component one by one, and then at the end there are many tutorials how to assemble them together, just like Legos in SolidWorks. So it's really cool, which costs $200 that comes free with that course. There is another PDF, $130 comes free with that course. And if you go to my website, solidworkstutorials.net, you see I have over 120 tutorials for sheet metal, weldments, product design and techniques, which are not free. Again, those are $120 per year for the membership to access those tutorials. You get that also is included, and many more, support and so on. The course has over 18 hours of content to teach you SolidWorks, divided into beginner, intermediate, and professional, plus CSWA and CSWP. So if you want to take those exams, again, it's a perfect tool for it, and you have all the practicing materials. I'll be sure to show you more about it in the next live session. Today got a little bit out of hand. It got longer than 1 hour, but I'll get back to you in the live session. Make sure to click the bell button to not miss the next one. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your questions. I'll see you soon. Take care.